Hey guys, and welcome back to How to Create a Membership Site with Zero Coding. This is the last part in the series, how to create a process for cancellations for your membership site. One of the negatives of creating a membership site with zero coding is that we need to have a process for cancellations because it's not integrated, it's not going to happen automatically. So I'm going to show you how to do that in this video. And basically what we're going to be doing is using a spreadsheet to manage our cancellations or to manage our customers. And here is the spreadsheet that we'll be using to manage our cancellations. It doesn't look like much because it doesn't need to be much. I've made this spreadsheet available for you for free because, hey, I'm that kind of guy. You can get it. Just go to pelt.co/cancel sheet. Now, it will be read-only for you. So if you want to have it to use yourself, click File, click Make a Copy. You can go ahead and name that copy, then click OK. And that will then save it to your Google Docs account. So you will need to have a Google account to be able to do this. Now, what will happen is when someone cancels their membership, you will get a notification like this one that the following subscription has been cancelled by the customer. Now, I am using a product called Snappy Checkout, which I'm using to collect recurring payments. You can go ahead and sign up for that through my affiliate link at pelt.co/SC. And if you do that, I would absolutely appreciate it. So we're going to use this spreadsheet to manage our customers. Okay, so we can see from this email that someone has cancelled their account. So what I'm going to do straight away is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to copy that email address and I'm going to go ahead and paste it into here. Okay, paste it in so we can see that email address there. Now in this spreadsheet, the two columns of yellow are really the only two columns that you need to fill out. You can go through and you can add more details if you want, but you don't necessarily have to. And you'll see as we go through why that's the case. Okay, so now I need to find out when this person last paid. And so when does their subscription end? So let's go ahead and go to snappycheckout.com and we're going to go ahead and sign in. So I've signed in, I now need to find my customer. So let's go ahead and paste my customer's email address into the search bar and we can see my customer has come up here. What I wanna do is go to the payments tab and I can see that they paid today and they paid a dollar and they've now canceled it. So I know that they're on a monthly subscription. And so what I do with my membership sites is they're canceled, they'll see out the term of their membership. In this case, it's 1 month. So today's the 7th of December, 2015, which means their membership will cancel on the 7th of January, 2016. So let's go back to our cancellation spreadsheet and date canceled, I'm going to put in the date that their membership will end. January the 7th, 16, which is American. Okay, so 7th of January, 2016, I can see that their membership is canceled. Now, basically, we just need to wait until their membership is canceled. And then we'll move on to the next step, which is to actually go and delete those customers from your membership site. And I'll show you how to do that in 1 second. But let's pretend that this person actually canceled 1 month and 1 day ago. So they're actually ending on December 6, 2015. And we can see that this has gone red. So this spreadsheet is set up that if the date that's canceled is actually before today's date, so it looks at today's date, if it's before today's date, it goes red. So you always know when someone's in the red and we need to move on to this step and go ahead and delete their account. So let's go ahead and do that now. So we need to log into the back end of our membership site. So you go to mymembershipsite.com/wp-admin. So for me, it's my.melee.co/wp-admin. We're then going down to the wishlist member settings and we're going to this members tab here. And this is going to show us all of the members that we have. And currently I just have one because this isn't a real membership site. It's just to help you guys out. So what we do is we want to go ahead and find our members. So I hit Command F on a Mac or you hit Control F on a PC. And I'm going to go ahead and paste in that email. Now, obviously, I don't need to do this because I have one member. But when you have hundreds of members, it just makes it so much easier. So all I need to do is go ahead and tick that member, select an action to go ahead and delete selected users. And then I click the Go button. I then confirm all of these things and that member is now deleted. I'll then go back and update my spreadsheet and I'll change this from active to deleted. And I like to go ahead and make that red so I know that that person's deleted. Or alternatively, I can just go ahead and delete the email and delete the date canceled. And then my spreadsheet is just starting from scratch again. I'm now going to show you how to manually cancel customer subscriptions. So let's say a customer goes to their account page and they click to cancel their account and they fill out this form to cancel their account. You will then receive this email that's saying that they want to cancel their account. What's the address? How do you go ahead and manually do that within Snappy Checkout? Well, again, let's go ahead and copy that email address. We'll go to our dashboard in Snappy Checkout. We'll go ahead and paste in the email address and click search. And then we want to go to subscriptions and we want to go ahead and manually cancel this. So we'll just hover over this X and click cancel subscription and then go ahead and click cancel now. So that subscription is now canceled and they will no longer be charged. Now that they're canceled, we go ahead and we put in their email address and we do the same process to find out what is the last date that they made payment, so when will their membership end. So again, let's say it ends on the 6th of December 2015. We can now see that that's red and so we can go ahead and delete that customer from our membership site. So that's how you manually cancel customer subscriptions. Now this is optional, but you can also use this spreadsheet to track new customers. So when a customer pays, you'll get an email address like this saying you've just received a payment, a product, what they signed up for, the price that they're paying, and then their name and their email address there. So what you can do is go ahead and put this in. So we're going to put in their name, their email address, their date joined. So let's put December 7th, 2015. Let's pretend they haven't canceled at this time. A monthly membership, price $1. We're using Snappy Checkout. And if they use any other emails to sign up, I'd go ahead and put that in here because you actually get this notification as well from Wishlist Member when a new person signs up. So if they use a different email address there to what they used in Snappy Checkout, then I would go ahead and put that in there. So you can actually use this to track your existing members. You can also say, okay, well, they canceled within 1 month, so they're gonna end on the 7th of January, 2016. And then I can begin to track how long are people staying members, and you can go into all that detail about your membership site. Again, that is optional, so it's something you can do if you want, but you don't absolutely have to. So there you have the last part in the series, how to create a process for cancellations for your membership site. And that completes this series, how to create a membership site with zero coding. Let's quickly go over exactly what we covered, and you can go back and refresh yourself with the videos if you need to. So first, we just went into an overview of how to create a membership site with zero coding. We talked about buying the correct domain name for your membership site. We talked about setting up hosting for your membership site, connecting your domain name and hosting, and then finally getting your membership site set up on WordPress. We then talked about how to use Wishlist Member to protect your content and allow you to manage members and so forth. We talked about adding content and protecting that content on our membership site. We went through creating a good site structure and great user experience for your customers when they're using your membership site. We talked about changing the themes and making it look exactly the way you want it to look. And then we went into details like how to create a sales page for your membership site and how to collect payments for your membership site and integrate that with Wishlist Member. And then lastly was this episode, how to create a process of cancellations for your membership site. So we've covered a lot in this series on how to create a membership site with zero coding. I hope that this has helped you a lot. If you want to get access to all of the course materials, or if you have any questions you want to ask, please head over to pelt.co/MS, and that MS stands for membership sites. Or if you want our help to set up your membership site for you, you're stuck, you can't do it yourself, you want to pay us to help you, go ahead to pelt.co/services to see what we have to offer. I'm Ryan McLean, and if you want to see more series like this one or more how-to videos, you can go to pelt.co and see all of the stuff that we have to offer, or go to pelt.co/YouTube to see our YouTube channel. Until next time, guys, keep learning.